got Brent Hammond coming out, nicknamed Pinto. Age is 21, he's 6'2". Came in officially at 176.8 pounds. Fighting out of Richmond, Indiana with a 7'6'5 top team. Walking down with him is his corner, Skyler Neithery and LD Carter. This will be his first match, but he's got 2 years of training experience. He would say his style is boxing. Now this would be considered a 170-pound fight. And I feel like this 7'6'5 top team has had somebody the last two fights. Hammond coming in, black trimmed with pink. Now with Stephen Huber coming out, nicknamed the Reaper. Age is 24, he's 5'10". He came in officially at 169.6 pounds, fighting out of Richmond, Indiana. Originally from Palm Bay, Florida. His training facility he's training at right now is Boot Camp Boxing. Gus is his coach, and his corners are Gus and Marcus. Now, Stefan's coming in with 2 years of experience, 1-1 in kickboxing. He's an orthodox fighter, and now his style is kickboxing. He's coming out with black shorts. And again, we want to thank Handyman on Demand, Tom Combs Auto Repair, and Atkins Property Solutions. Without our sponsors, these events would be so much harder to do, so we really appreciate them. Now we're set for round one. Here we go. I got a touch of gloves. Here we go. We got an orthodox stance from Huber. It looks like a southpaw stance from Hammond. Ooh, Hammond went with that straight left and went over the shoulder. Ooh, Huber with the body shots. His hands are real low. He's hunting. Ooh, a little slip there. He's back up. I heard slow down from one of the corners. That's good advice. Ooh, but these guys coming in swinging heavy. Hands are low.
Oh, ooh, that was a nice hit.
Huber lands a good right, and now it's putting them both into a frenzy of punches here. Huber ducking under and throwing up with the right. But Hammond's coming back each time. We had just a brief moment of a dark fight here. Or thought they were going to turn on the glow in the dark lights or something.
It's like a disco.
That's just a joke. My daughter's done a glow in the dark wrestling tournament before. Maybe a future event for kickboxing.
Nice hit by
Huber lands a good left there. He's coming back with a right. He's coming with some heavy hands. But these guys got their hands real low. Ooh. But they're both quick with their hands. Ooh, Huber with a quick little left hook there. And he's landed his last two left hooks. But he comes in with his hands real low. End of round one. Huber's coming in with his corners, Gus and Marcus. And Hammond's coming in with Skyler Netherly and L.D. Carter with his corners. And Cassie Pope as our ring girl in there for round two. Now I think the corner of Huber. I believe the corner of Huber might be telling him to kind of keep his hands up and hit the angle a little bit more to land that left hook. Now Hammond, I think his corner might be telling him to hunker down a little bit, is what I would hope they'd be saying. Hunker down a little bit, keep his hands up, and then after Huber throws some, he'll be able to start connecting.
Touch a glove.
Ooh, both these coming in there swinging. Again, some wild swings and head dips and uppercut throws.
Oh,
Hammond. Huber has a big right, but Hammond does not stop. He keeps coming. Oh, he landed two really good shots. But Huber's still going. Huber's landing his shots on Hammond now. Look at this.
Back and
forth.
Man,
we got some shots, and these guys can take some hits. There we go. We're in a clinch. Working their way out. There you go. Both these guys are measuring each other up now. Taking some time to assess. So Huber went to reach for something. A little bit of missing. Hammond with some good head movement on that one. And if your hands are that low, we got to have some head movement.
Something's going to happen.
Huber's corner, giving them great advice. When you're fighting an orthodox versus a southpaw, you always want to move to the outside of that front foot. And that's what they're asking Huber to do, is move to the left, to the outside of Hammond, so he can land those shots. Hammond got smart, made a clinch, but now they're both back out to neutral territory. Both reaching for these shots.
Hammond's
throwing him in now, trying to throw heavy hands. Huber with the response. Ooh, good uppercut by Huber. Ooh, good right hand, good left hand. Puts Hammond down.
Hammond is down. Great.
We got our first knockdown. And we got the end of the round there. But we got to give that round to Huber, staying in it and chased down Hammond and landed that big shot. Actually, it was two big shots that put him down. Here we go for our first round three. Cassie Pope back in there for her first time holding that round three. What an end to that round, though. Hopefully that got everybody at home even out of their couches. Or if you're sitting on the floor, standing up. Go for round three. I think this is going to be a good round right here. With the way these guys are fighting, I'm willing to say there could possibly be a knockout this round. These guys touch gloves. I'm going to see if Huber still remembers that advice to keep circling left, because that's when he started landing those big shots. He started listening to his corner, moving to the left. But Hammond's got to do the same thing. He's got to move to the right. Get to the out. Ooh!
Oh,
Huber,
great shot
left.
By Huber.
Landed that straight left. Hammond throwing body shots even on that. And they're measuring each other up. And we're seeing a little fatigue coming in this round. Let's see if these guys can keep it going. Hammond measuring it out with his glove, with a little jab there. And he's used that jab to measure it out. But I'd say even though Hammond's a little taller, I don't think there's much of a length difference in their reach. Ooh, Huber coming through, landing a big right.
Shots.
He's still hunting. Hands real low, but swinging real big. And he lands him. Huber's landing him.
Huber's got landing him forward. Still throwing.
Hunt for that uppercut. Ooh, big right by Hammond. And then the response by Huber with the right. This orthodox and southpaw will make for some big shots. Break by the ref. Here we go. We're back at it. Both of them pawing out jabs. Ooh, big hook by Huber there. Ooh, good hits by Huber. Landing right in front of us. Here we go. We got a toss. But he comes back with the jab. But Hammond responds. Huber's not stopping,
Huber's
though. He's coming
stopping.
In with left, right, left, right.
So many shots.
Now we get a little bit clenched to slow it down. Our ref's going to break that up. Hammond's low. We got 30 seconds left, I keep hearing called. Hammond's got his mouth wide open, though. We got a Huber's starting to see it. I think Huber's starting to come in to hunt for something. Huber's hungry for it.
Huber
There's
is
the wrong
right
hand at the end of
right
the round. Hand. Wrong on the KO, but man, what a good fight we had there. And there's the sportsmanship I love to see in this sport. I say, I mean, I'm friends with most of the guys I fought. And it's amazing. Even the last guy I fought, Angel Corps and BKFC, still giving me good comments and positive things on social media. And I love to see when us martial artists can just keep lifting each other up. That sportsmanship is everything in this. We can go out there and just try to kill each other. And then at the end, have a hug and start making each other better. And you haven't heard him much. My son, Ty Vo, is on the mic here, and he understands what I'm talking about, I hope. Right, Ty?
A little bit. Sometimes you just don't like him after, though.
Yeah, but that'll give you that motivation to get better, right?
Yeah.
It's all about motivation. So we're going to go to the judges' scorecards on this one. But, again, there was a knockdown in that second round by Huber. So, I mean, I'm saying this fight's got to go to Huber. He definitely won that last round, got the knockdown in the second round. But here's for our official decision.
Unanimously, 30-26.